This is most likely the original stretcher of the Maclise. We know for certain that it was actually used since 1879 and possibly even before that. And I'm here to actually stabilize the joints to ensure its stability. After stabilization of all the joints, there will be an additional aluminium frame put on the back to actually give additional rigidity to the frame to safeguard the canvas for eternity. The whole frame is constructed with several joints. On the corners, we have a bridle joint, whereby the tenon goes into the housing, and the other parts are actually jointed with sliding dovetails. It's constructed in a way that it actually can become a flat pack, just like IKEA, so you can actually transport it much easier and bring it wherever you want to bring it. To make it easier to reassemble, the original maker put actually numbers on every joint. In this case, you can see a 4 here, which actually is supposed to be the 6, because the 5 is here and the 4 is here, so it's 4, 5, 6. And these numbers together will then help you to put every original joint with the right component in the right location and in the right alignment. Some of the repairs I've done are these pieces we've put in to actually strengthen these vertical members. We've used a similar joint to the existing ones which are in there, which are slightly inconsistent in as far that they don't have a real purpose to be there. Another strange part is the widening of the stretcher, which we can't really explain at this point either. So the whole stretcher is actually full of mysteries, and hopefully we'll be able to at some point solve all of these.